Well, hello everybody, CB Repair Guy here. Today we're going to do a video on the Longhorn. It says 400 watt, high power, American style, durable RF amp, 10 meter radio. So this is AM sideband, FM CWPA style radio, 400 plus watt. Let's get this thing out of the box, see what it looks like, and let's just see how reliable it really is. Well, we've got the radio out of the case. Let's take a look at it. We've got our frequency counter, normal things like that, volume, squelch, mic gain, RF gain, echo and time, talk back and dimmer, mode switch, AM sideband, FM CWPA, up and down for our band here, noise blanker, SWR or S meter switch for our meter, our Roger beep switch, high and low. Then we have a power high and low switch. Then down here it says fine and RF power. And I'm not sure about that. It looks to me like here is a button for RF power high and low. Okay. Then if we go down here, we have fine. Come on. Focus. Fine. And then we have RF power. And I'm not quite sure if that's a misprint, and this would be your fine and coarse clarifier, and this is your high and low power switch. We'll have to do some checking, but something's not printed right there. I'm not sure what that is. And then, of course, we have our channel selector, which, by the way, is an encoder. It is not a switch. It's very, very flimsy feeling. It doesn't have those good solid clicks. You can tell that it's an encoder. Okay. Now, I'm going to try to turn this radio over with one hand. You can see that the bottom's a little different. Huge heat sink. Huge heat sink. They did put a little bigger speaker in, which is mounted, looks like, externally here. And then it's got a huge fan. I don't know if you can see that, but that's got a huge muffin fan with a grill over it. I'm going to say this thing's going to get pretty hot, most likely. So anyway, we've got this outside look. Let's spin it around. You can see the back. Give you an idea of what you've got. Okay. You've got my cable mixed in with it. This is our antenna. This is our power cord that comes in. Quick disconnect. Which the other quick disconnect is in the box. Here you can see the wires running to the fan. Coming right out of the heat sink here. Going right up into the fan. Down here at the bottom, we've got our PA external speaker and probably CW. Oops, I took the screws out already. Yeah, CW key. And then for you, those of you wondering, this plug right here was the plug that's plugged where the coax would normally come out of the radio. But since it's got the amp and everything, it comes out up here. But that's where the coax would normally screw into your radio. All right, well, we've already got the screws out, obviously, so let me get this thing flipped over, and we'll get the covers off, and we'll be back, and let's take a look at the inside. Okay, we're back. We've got the covers off. I don't know what all's in there, but it looks like there's a lot of stuff in there, doesn't it? Well, let's take a short look. Let's look at, first of all, let's look at what board we're using. We're using a Ranger EPT 6950 16A board. So that's a... the 6950 16A board. Just for your information, this is all surface mount. For the most part, everything in here is surface mount. Connector for your board, for your repeater board, shift board, which would go here. Conversion for this particular radio. Let's see. Let me get where we can see it, or where I can see it through the camera. Your key plugs in right there to convert it, okay? And then you'll notice that each individual section of this radio pretty much is blocked off. Your VCO section, this is your TX section, your receive section, which is not something we haven't seen before in some of the later Ranger radios, but this, I like this being totally insulated and isolated. Your audio section is all over here. This is your audio section around by the transformer and all this right in through here. When we go over to the output section or the PA section of the radio, you'll notice you have your driver, pre-driver, driver, final. And then these last two transistors here are like a small amplifier, basically. This driver drives these last two transistors like an amp. And that's what gives us our power, which goes through the tuning circuits and comes out here in this coax. And if you follow that coax up and over and down, we're going to get into the amplifier section of the radio. So here we can see our main power leads coming in. Our positive, our negative is over here, this blue wire. Excuse me. This is our input from the radio. Comes in through our transformer. Now, what you want to see is, or what you want to notice is, excuse me, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 output transistors, okay? We've got our combiners, which combined all this power together, which is going to take us out. Where'd our output go? Right here. This is our output. Better get to where you can see. Right here, this black. And you can see the coax right there. This is the output. Okay. Now, this is built okay. You can see kind of some of the bodgy soldering work that was done. That was hand soldered there. That one's been worked on. I think they've touched that up a little bit. Not so much there. You go over here and you see that looks pretty much factory. Looks good. Looks fairly good factory. Very difficult to see, but see that the soldering on that looks good. Soldering over there looks relatively good. I had to look at it off camera so I could see it better. Okay, so that's going to be our, as they say, 400 watts, but actually they'll do quite a bit more than that. When we get it tuned up, we'll see what it does do. So you can get a gist of the radio. I'll flip it over here so you can see the other side. Not a lot to see. Pretty plain back there. It's got some pretty beefy traces, which you can see here, running over to supply your outputs. This is your regulator. Your audio chip is right here. This is your 8-volt regulator right here. Pretty much the standard Ranger layout, to be honest with you. You know, your PLL section's over here. Nice. That's always a nice work. A little bit of a bodged on wire from the factory. TX mixer here. Just a standard radio. Nothing special. Nothing to get excited about. You know, how well is it built? Yeah, it's a 10-meter radio built by Ranger. How well is it built? It's built fair to middling, that's what I would say. You know, did they get heat sink compound on there? It looks like Each of these transistors do have some heat sink compound. That's one of the things you need to check with these guys when they're building this stuff, whether they actually do put the heat sink compound on. You know, the this capacitor right here, what size is it? If I can see, it's a 2200. So they did upgrade that from 1000 to a 2200, which is a good thing. But they went right back to 1000 here, which could have been upgraded a little bit, which they didn't do. If you'll notice your PA section, all these coils, the size of them, they're good size, a lot bigger to handle the current. That's, you've got your bias controls here for your transistors. Voltage regulator here. So essentially, and then of course here's all your different controls for your AM power, your sideband power, your modulation, low power, your meters, and your well, it doesn't have, if it had the modulation, there would have been a let's see here. If there would have been modulation, there would have been the pot for it, but they're not using it in this particular radio. So there's your sideband limit, which you can see right there. It's marked. Everything's marked on the board. AM modulation, low power. I mean, you can pretty much see your, this is called emission, but this was actually your balance, sideband balance. It takes a carrier out. VC1. Adjust your 10240, which is back here, right there. Your 455 kilohertz filter. You know, it is what it is, guys. It's not a bad radio as far as it looks. It's awful pricey radio. But I guess the next thing that we want to see is to see what will it do. So what we're going to do is we're going to hook it up. We're going to show you what it does stock after it's converted. And then we're going to do a quick tune on it and see what it does after that. Give me just a minute and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. And we've got the radio all hooked up. I figured out a little bit more about those RF power and the power switch. So one of them turns the amp off and one of them turns the amp on. And then you've got your variable power. So we've got our variable power turned all the way down, the amplifier off. Mic gain is turned all the way up, okay? That's where we're at right now. So let's go over here and look at our dead key. And you can see on our meter that we're setting on the 10-watt scale. Just a little bit over 1 watt is what we're at. Excuse this mess. We're going to flip this off and we're going to go to 100-watt scale. So you'll still want to be looking at the bottom scale of the meter. Hello, 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 hello. So with the RF power all the way down, looks like we're doing, what, 10 watts? About 10 watts is all that thing's swinging. Let me turn that, get that up a little bit where you can see it better. Hold this and do that. So you can see 10 watts. We're going to turn the RF power now up on the radio. To half. It's sitting at 12 o'clock right now. 30 watt dead key. 80 watts. So we're going to turn it wide open. About a 35 watt dead key. About 90 watts. So that's what we can say we've got with our amplifier off. All right. So let's come back over here. So we're going to turn our amplifier on. We're going to put our dead key all the way down again. RF power is all the way down. So now we're not just running these fanless, we're running our amplifier as well, okay? So we're going to go to a... back up here to our 10-watt scale. RF power's all the way down. So you can see we have a 4-watt dead key. We're going to flip this up to a 100-watt scale. So we're on a 100-watt scale. Look at about a 35-watt swing. Okay, so let's turn our RF power up to about 12 o'clock. All right, so we're kicking in now. We've got a 100-watt scale, or 100-watt dead key. Let's see what we got. Pegging a 250-watt scale. So let's go up to our 500-watt. Now we're on the 500-watt, which is the middle scale. So we're right at almost 400 watts. We're going to turn the RF power all the way up. And as you can see, with the amplifier in and the RF power wide open, as you can see that it's wide open, we're seeing 400 watts of swing. All right, so that's an untuned radio just out of the factory. That's what the radio produces. Let me do a quick tune-up on this, just a quick tune, and come back and see if it improves any. Be right back. Okay, we're back. Now, we've got just a quick tune-up done. Nothing special, just something to see what we can make this thing do. And we're going to see what we got. Where the amplifier is off, RF power is all the way down. Let's go over here and see what we've got. Let's see if we can bring this meter in a little better. There. All right, so RF power is all the way down. Looks like we're at just about a 1-watt dead key, okay? Now let's go to 100-watt. So we're at 100-watt. Remember, that's the amp off. So from a 1-watt dead key, we're swinging over 100 watts. We're on the 250-watt scale, which is your top scale. Which is running about 125 watts. Okay, that's with the RF power all the way down. Let's turn the RF power up to about 12 o'clock. About 125 watts. So it looks like that's going to be about max. We'll open it wide open. RF power is all the way up. But we're getting 125 watts PP out of this with the amplifier off. Okay. Now let's turn the amplifier on. Our RF power is all the way down. Let's see what kind of dead key we get. We're going to go back to 100 watts. So we're at our 100-watt dead key, our 100-watt scale. Let's move this on down and see what we're really getting. With our RF power all the way down and the amp on, about a 4-watt dead key. Okay. We're going to go to the 250-watt scale. So we're all the way down. Our RF power is all the way down. The amplifier is on. The mic gain's all the way up. Let's see what we got. Bang. 250 watts. No problem. All right. So let's pick our... we're going to go to the high scale. Turn this off. Put this on 500 watts. So we're on a 500-watt scale. So that's the middle scale. See what we got. Oh, bang, 500 watts right to the wall. All right, so let's turn the 500 watt off. Let's go to 1,000 watt scale, which is the bottom scale, okay? Oh, 600 watts. So we've got 600 watt output with a 4 watt dead key. We're going to turn our RF power up to about 12 o'clock. You notice our power dropped just a little bit. We're going to turn our power wide open. Our power dropped back to 500 watts. We're going to turn it all the way back down. Right at 600 watts PEP. All right, guys. That's 600 watts PEP on this thing with the RF power all the way down. With the RF power all the way up, we'll see around 500 watts. Now, let me explain a couple of things to you. Number one, I'm not running this with big enough power wires right now. As you can see, let me zoom in. You can see what I'm running power-wise for that. Not big enough. I'm not telling you what the maximum, absolute maximum wattage is this, but we know we can see 600 watts. I would say on a proper setup station, 650, maybe even 700. But we'll say 650, pretty simple. If I can see 600 with the setup that I'm running here, we should see 650 pretty easy. As far as everything is cool, regulator's cool, our fans never kicked on the amp. So we're in pretty good shape in that direction. I just think that it's a little strange about the clarifier, which I'm going to find out about. I didn't realize that it didn't have a coarse clarifier. But the rest of the radio seems to be pretty good shape. The amplifier seems to work exceptionally well. Radio looks good. The front of it looks good. All the controls. I wanted to show you, if I can. Hold on here. Let me unplug the power. Bear with me as I try to turn this around. Right here is that encoder, and you can see how small it is. You can see absolutely how small that is, and that's your channel changer. So that's an issue. You definitely don't want to have this up in a cubbyhole hanging on that. You'll wear it out real fast. But other than that, seems like a pretty decent radio, guys. I think it's going to last. The amplifier, I think, will last as long as you don't get it into some high SWR. Everything else is pretty standard. No problems that I see here. Build construction is pretty good for Ranger. It's just a pricey, expensive, high-powered radio. So there you have it, guys. If you're interested in one of these, we have them in stock. CustomCBRadios.com. That's the website. Our phone number is 812-420-1226. You can give us a call. Check us out on the web. Check us out on Facebook, Custom CB Radios. And other than that, hopefully we'll have some more videos coming along to show you a few different radios that's out and maybe some mods, maybe some repair. Just depends on how rambunctious I get. Well, this is the old CB Repair Guy saying thanks, guys. 7-3 to you. Appreciate you watching this video. Come back soon. If we can help you out in any way, let us know. Take care. Bye-bye.